हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम संजय मंगनानी फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ आर्य कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी जयपुर। दिस इज माय सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन हेलिकल स्प्रिंग। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी कवर्ड टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ हेलिकल स्प्रिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिराइव द स्ट्रेस एंड डिफ्लेक्शन इक्वेशन फॉर द हेलिकल स्प्रिंग। सो stresses in helical spring. Let we take a helical compression spring subjected to an axial force F as shown in this figure. Due to this force F, three types of stresses are produced in the spring. First is torsional shear stress tau 1. Second is transverse shear stress tau 2, and third is the stress is due to the curvature of the wire. As shown in the figure, the spring is subjected to an axial force F. Let the spring is cut from anywhere. So this diagram shows the free body diagram of the cutted part of the spring. Here this circular part is the cut section of the spring wire. So basically the force F, this force F produces two effects. First, it produces a torsional moment in clockwise direction. This is the force line. So this produces a torque in the clockwise direction. To balance this torque or twisting moment, an anticlockwise movement is produced at this section, which is equal to force, which is F, and perpendicular distance from the center line to this section, and this distance is d by 2. So twisting moment T is equal to F d by 2. This twisting moment T produces a torsional shear stress tau 1 as shown in this diagram. So this is the first effect of this axial force F. Also, to balance this force F, an equal and opposite force F is produced at this wire section. This force F is basically a tangential force for this section, and it produces a transverse shear stress tau 2, which is shown in this diagram, tau 2. So these two stresses, torsional shear stress tau 1 and transverse shear stresses tau 2, are the major stresses in spring wire. Third is the stresses due to the curvature of wire. In spring, the length of the inner fiber is less than the length of the outside fiber. So due to this, a stress concentration is occur at the inner side or inner fiber of the coil. So these are the three stresses which acts in the spring. It is very clear from this diagram that at the inner fiber, this is the inner fiber and this is the outer fiber of this section which we consider for the equilibrium. So at the inner fiber, these two stresses tau 1, this dotted line represents the torsional stress tau 1. So at inner fiber, these two stresses tau 1 and tau 2, both are in the same direction. So the stresses at inner fiber is higher than the stresses at outer fiber. At outer fiber, the stresses tau 1 and tau 2 is in opposite direction. So the maximum stresses occurred at the inner fiber of the coil. This is the inner fiber. Now we will derive the load stress equation for the helical spring. So first major stresses in the spring is the torsional shear stress, that is equal to tau 1. As we discussed in previous slide, that this axial force F produces a twisting moment T at the wire section. So we know that torque in a wire or rod is given by the T is equal to pi by 16 dq tau 1. Basically this is the torsion equation. From diagram it is clear that torque T is equal to force multiplied by perpendicular distance. This is the perpendicular distance from the force line to the section. This distance is d by 2. So torque is equal to F multiplied by d by 2. By equating these two equations, T is equal to F d by 2 and T is equal to pi by 16 dq tau 1, we get Fd by 2 is equal to pi by 16 d cube tau 1. So from this equation we get tau 1 is equal to 8fd pi d cube. So this is the torsional shear stress tau 1 acting in the spring wire. Second major stress is the transverse shear stress. As we discussed earlier, that to balance this axial force, an equal and opposite force F is produced at the section. Basically this force is the tangential force for this section and it produces a transverse shear stress tau 2. So we know that the formula for the transverse shear stress tau 2 is equal to shear load upon shear area, and shear load is the load F and shear area is the cross section area of the spring wire, that is equal to pi by 4 d square. So tau 2 is equal to F upon pi by 4 d square. So we get tau 2 is equal to 4 F upon pi d square. Now by combining these two stress, we will get the resultant stress tau. This is the resultant stress tau. So tau is equal to tau 1 plus minus tau 2. Here positive sign is used for inner edge and negative sign is used for outer edge. As we discussed in the last slide, that stresses is maximum at the inner edge as shown in this diagram. Again that at inner edge the stresses is tau 1 plus tau 2 and at outer edge the stresses are tau 1 minus tau 2. So the maximum stresses is occurred at the inner edge, that is equal to tau is equal to tau 1 plus tau 2. So by putting the value of tau 1 and tau 2 we get tau is equal to 8 fd pi d cube plus 4f pi d square. So by taking the common we get tau is equal to 8 fd pi d cube 1 plus d upon 2d. We know that capital D upon small d is equal to C. C is the spring index. So by we use C for this capital D by D. So we get tau is equal to 8 fd pi d cube 1 plus 1 upon 2c. By replacing this value in the bracket by the factor Ks, so we get tau is equal to 8 fd pi d cube multiplied by Ks, where Ks is the shear correction factor, that is equal to 1 plus 1 upon 2c. So we get the resultant stress, final resultant stress is equal to 8 fd upon pi d cube multiplied by Ks. So in the last equation, if we consider the stress concentration effect due to the geometry of the spring, the third stress in the spring is the stress due to the curvature of the spring. So if we consider this effect, then we use a factor K in place of Ks. This is the Ks, so we replace this factor Ks by the factor K. So we get the final resultant stress in the spring is tau is equal to 8 fd upon pi d cube K, where K is called the wall stress factor, which is given by the AM wall, and the value of the K is equal to 4C minus 1 upon 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by C, where C is the spring index. So this is the final equation of the stress in the helical spring. Now the deflection of the helical spring. We know that the torsion equation is equal to the P upon IP is equal to G theta by L is equal to tau by R, where theta is the angular deflection of the spring wire and L is the active length of the spring. In last lecture we have discussed about the active and inactive coil. So L is the active length of the spring. So L is equal to length of the one coil, which is equal to pi d multiplied by number of active coil, and number of active coil is the capital N, which we have discussed in the last lecture of the helical spring. So L is equal to pi d n. Here IP is the polar moment of inertia. So from this torsion equation we get theta is equal to TL divided by GIP. By putting the value of TL and IP in this equation we get theta is equal to T is equal to F D by 2, L is equal to pi D N, IP polar moment of inertia of the circular section, that is equal to pi by 32 D4, and G is the shear modulus. or modulus of rigidity. So we get theta is equal to 16 F d square n upon gd 4. So this is the final equation of theta is equal to 16 F d square n upon gd 4. Theta is the angular deflection of the wire. Now axial deflection. Concept of axial deflection and angular deflection is shown in this diagram. This is the theta. Basically this angle is the angular deflection theta, and this linear deflection is equal to delta. This is shown in this triangle. From this triangle, tan theta is equal to perpendicular is delta divided by base. Base is equal to d by 2. This distance is d by 2. So tan theta is equal to delta upon d by 2. For small values of theta, we can say that tan theta is equal to theta. So theta is equal to delta upon d by 2, or we can say that delta is equal to theta multiplied by d by 2. So substituting the value of theta from the previous slide, theta, put this value of theta, so we get delta is equal to 16 f d square n upon gd 4 multiplied by d by 2. By simplifying this equation, we get delta is equal to 8 f d cube n upon gd 4. So this is the final equation of the axial deflection equation of the spring. It can be written as, we know that d by d is equal to c, so we can put this d cube by small d cube, capital D cube by small d cube as c cube. So delta can be written as 8 f c cube n divided by g d. We can also calculate the stiffness from this equation. We know that stiffness of the spring is stiffness is equal to force per unit deflection. So from this equation, force F per unit deflection delta is equal to GD divided by 8 C cube N. So stiffness is equal to GD upon 8 C cube N. So this is all about the stress and deflection in the helical spring. In next lecture, we will solve some numerical of the helical spring. Thank you.